Since 1991, Pro Taper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, Pro Taper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Kickstart Podcast presented by our friends at Pro Taper. Today's show Today's show is co-sponsored by Sketchy Merch.
Hell yeah.
AlexRay.co, because it was a sketchy weekend in Indianapolis. Before we get to the good stuff, though, I mean, I have to say,
We need to make a commercial since it's co-sponsored.
Yeah, a co-sponsor.
We need to make a commercial.
But, yeah, Indianapolis Supercross went down this weekend. I made a surprise appearance. Even see, everyone in the pits were surprised. Like, oh, swap at an East Coast
every
race.
Time
and
you
I'm
go
all,
to
bitch,
a race.
I was at Minneapolis.
They even said that West Coast, too, though.
I know.
They're like, oh, why are you here?
Well, anyway, I even surprised Anton. It was great. He was doing his news break on Friday, recording, talking to Jason Anderson. And I'm talking into my GoPro like, oh, here I am in Indy. And Anton doesn't even know. And I walk around to the side and I film him. His face was perfect. He's like trying to be all serious, asking these questions. Whoa.
Yeah, I was very rattled. You were the last person I was expecting to see. Like, literally the last person. Because we had even when you said something the other day, you were like, oh, yeah, Indy Supercross this weekend. And I was like, yeah, just Indy. And, yeah, then I look over and there you are. But it's so funny now, too, that when you told me why you were really there, I started thinking about it. And I was like, I was at the conversation you had with your daughter when she wanted to go on that trip the first time. So it's like, I should have known this was coming.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so.
Yeah, it was after Paula National. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So I think, you know, Megan, my youngest, studied abroad in Japan for a semester. And two of her dorm mates from Indiana, so.
Yeah.
And then this was her 24th birthday weekend, dude.
That's awesome.
And so we went out there and surprised Anton, made a sneak attack, went out there, lightened the load because he had a big baby shower yesterday. And baby Anton is what, only like a month away? 6 weeks away?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Like, supposed to be like 6 weeks away. Wow.
Seems like yesterday we just found out, and now it's almost here. It's mm-hmm. crazy.
Oh, yeah. Tell me about it. I've been living it.
Hey, so does this mean that maybe we might see Don at some outdoor races instead of Anton?
I don't know. I mean, I've already planned and booked all my travel out, and it's funny that you say that because this has been a big, like, conversation other people have been having with me. Yeah, we got to try to figure out after we get back from Seattle, like, when exactly he's supposed to come. Mm-hmm. You know, it's really like the big window in April. So yeah, just trying to get that figured out. So we'll see. I hope. I like when Don's at the races too. It's fun.
Are you doing anything crazy? Like, my buddy's got a due date pretty close to you, and we're talking about like tailgating in the parking lot of the hospital and maybe shooting some fireworks off or something.
Oh, did that be badass? Is there any way it could be on the 23rd? Of April.
Why the 23rd?
Because that's mine and my mom's birthday.
Oh, what day is? I don't know. We'll try. I have a date in mind too, but we're trying to figure out that one too. But it's still kind of far. Hey, the little man's gonna get here when he gets here.
Hell yeah!
I'm just hoping it's not when I'm like sitting on a runway, flying like to or from somewhere, and then I can't like get off the plane, you know, because I would just freak.
I guess we need to tune that in, dial that in, and have some flights on standby and stuff, huh?
Just in case, right?
This was a conversation that we were bound to have, you know, soon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll be good. It'll be good.
Okay, well, anyway, Indy Supercross, we show up. I guess it was 70s all week.
Yeah.
It was raining press day.
Yeah, raining on press day, just shit
day.
Weather.
And it was cold on Saturday, huh?
Yeah, and there was a lot of fans still outside walking around.
Did you think so? Because I thought the fan
party or whatever was kind of sparse compared to like California.
I mean, yeah, but I mean, for how the weather was, were diehard fans that were out there just
on
the TV. It sounded insane. Like, I think when
it was packed.
When Jet won the heat race or whatever, you thought like the Colts just scored a touchdown or interception or something. It was insane.
Yeah.
So
The inside was packed.
Okay, just but outside
the pit part. I don't know. Mm-hmm.
That's the most people I've seen at Indy in a couple years, quite some time. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes it can be, like anybody knows, this time of year in the Midwest, like you could be clear and have an awesome sunny day, or it could be like what it was Saturday, or you could get snow. And they've gotten snow the last few times, you know. So, yeah, it was good to see so many people show up.
Hmm. Yeah, the thing that's kind of a bunk about cold races or poor weather races is all you guys put those windows up, right?
Yeah.
In your semis.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, obviously it's to keep the weather out and the heat in, because you guys all have those heaters. But like for fans that are doing the pit party thing, it's just kind of lame. And then KTM especially, because their walls are solid orange.
Yeah.
And you can't see shit.
Yeah. That's why I made a point a few times to go outside of the semi out in the cold and, you know, meet with some fans and sign some autographs and stuff. And obviously, like, I had my little QR code for my merch. I would sign it and everything, get it out. You know,
so. Is that working for you?
It is, yeah. This was actually the first weekend that I had put some stuff out like that. So, it was a good turnaround. So, yeah, I liked it.
Nice. Okay, so what do you think? Should we start the show off with the elephant in the room?
That's what everyone's going to.
The fucking elephant. Oh, me? Yeah. Talk about the crowd being loud. Holy shit, right?
Yeah.
What's that feel like, A-Ray?
It feels like, holy shit, this is probably on TV, and this is probably going to be bad. I mean, that's probably what – I mean, immediately once it started happening, I'm just like, all right, this is definitely being aired on national television, and it's probably fucking – you know what I mean? But
– yeah. Okay, I put Anton on hold. Are you there, sir?
Yeah I'm here.
Okay, so, Anton, we have a guest on the Kickstart Podcast today by the name of Deven Raper.
Oh, hell yeah.
I like how he texts you back. I fucking shot him a text this morning. He didn't text me back.
He's probably saving it for the show.
Yeah, I guess so.
You know? So we decided to address the elephant in the room in the Kickstart Podcast, Deven, and how should we do this? Like I kind of feel like...
I mean, I can explain my side first.
Okay, let's hear your side first.
All right, so pretty much we're in the heat race. I think it's Rod Bell, Cade, Amart, like all in front of me, like right there in the group, right? And I'm pretty sure Deven was right behind me.
And you're in ninth.
Yeah, I think I'm in ninth. He's in tenth.
Mm-hmm.
And then we go through the whoops. I'm in the middle of the whoops. Amart's on the left side. He goes like in the berm, and he cuts down, so I try to cut down a little bit tighter than him. And there was a rut right there on the inside. My front wheel misses the rut, and then my rear wheel kind of, like, gets into the rut, and it's sliding up the face of the jump. And I just lose all my momentum. And I jump the jump, and I land crooked, and I come to a complete stop on the landing. That's totally my bad. And then, obviously, he's pretty close behind me.
Mr. Raper.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it took me a while to, like, I really just sat down and thought about this because – it took me a bit because at first I was like, well, fuck, like, why is he pissed? He fucking landed on me at first. But then I was like, we're in a race. And I thought to a second, it all happened really fast. So I was like, well, I land right there. I come to a complete stop and he's already like in my back. So I feel like he had nowhere to go.
Mm-hmm.
And then obviously you see the crash and then fucking Bubba, dude. Holy shit.
You got smoked.
Dude, I legitimately just got smoked by a motorcycle. And that's happened to me once before, too, in Detroit. I think 2016, Dustin Pipes did the same shit off the start.
Really?
Yeah.
So was he even on the ground when he hit you, or was he jumping off your bike into your body? It looked like he was airborne.
Dude, it looked like he was trying to triple in, and he cased it with my body, pretty much.
Yeah, he saw an opportunity to take another guy out. He's like, oh, I'm going to pin it.
Yeah, pretty much. So, yeah, I don't know. I didn't see if it was flaggers or what. I mean, that was pretty quick, too. We were off in that gully, so... I'm sure he couldn't really see where we were because we were like on the ground, and then that happened. And I get up, and then obviously like Devin's mad and he's fucking like yelling at me. I don't know. I don't even remember what the fuck he was saying, but I
didn't think a guy would that makes money off the term sketchy. We get so triggered by someone else calling them sketchy. I don't know.
Well, honestly, I couldn't even hear what you were saying, but I just know that you were fucking yelling something, and I was just like, well, fuck you, bro. And then that's whenever, like, because, you know, whenever we come off the track, like, as racers, like, anytime someone, like, pushes us or, like, takes us out on the corner, we always over exaggerate the first 5 minutes after the race, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But this is in the middle of the race. So, like, all that adrenaline is still going. We still have, like, tensions are high, fucking testosterone's through the roof.
Yeah.
So, like, he's pissed, I'm pissed, and it was just worst case fucking scenario, right? Mm-hmm. And then I'm just like, well, fuck you. And then, like, I shove him, and then he just drops his bike, and then it's fucking, then that's all she wrote, right? So, I mean, I fucked up in the turn. I fucked up over the jump. He landed on my back. So that was on me. I shoved first, although, like, I mean, he was saying words, but it's all on me, I feel like. So
it was, yeah, it just was on top of, like, us having – I haven't made a main yet. I think Alex only made, like, one main. I was feeling good. I've qualified the best I have all year, and we were in good position, you know, and to transfer through. And on top of what he said, just not making a main, and then now it's like the night's ruined. Now we got last gate pick for LCQ if we didn't fight. And I was just I was pretty pissed, and was just like, you know, motherfucker and shit. And then I was like so blown away that he hit me, and I was like, oh hell, I'm not gonna let him take me out and then hit me. Fuck that.
Yeah, I mean, like I texted him this morning. I'm like, dude, like, you know me, you've known me for years. I'm not a fighter. Like, I'm more of a lover. You know,
I was,
I mean,
laughing,
like,
because in the video, you obviously have two trash wrists, right? So you didn't throw a punch. You threw an elbow.
No, my wrist, dude. I swear, if I had punched him and my hand would have hit his helmet, it would have just exploded. Folded. Yeah, it just fell off. Yeah, it fell off.
Like a mannequin.
I know. All these comments of people are like, these guys need boxing lessons. I'm like, dude, I was thinking that wouldn't get us disqualified. That was just more of like a game of like uncle, you know? Like,
yeah, we're just
holding
like pushing
down.
Yeah, we're just like pushing each other.
Punches, like,
yeah.
So why are they getting disqualified? But yeah, that was dumb.
Yeah.
Hey, Deven, what's it like when you're going to land on someone? What is that feeling like? And B, did you realize it was Alex when you're in the air?
Oh yeah, I realized it was Alex and Amart the first two laps, and I was at first I was like, you know, I know they qualified well, and I was like, my plan is just to stick with them, and then I was running with them for the first couple laps, you know, the track's crazy. There's some stakes everywhere, and I was just trying not to make a mistake. And then I got up close, and then, you know, that happened. And when he was in the air, I was thinking, oh shit, like I thought I was gonna land into his back. Like, I was, there's nowhere I could go. I couldn't save it. I was already in the air.
Yeah, front wheel snagged me a little bit in the back.
Yeah.
But
so I knew I was going down, and basically was just leaning to the left and kind of let go of the bike as soon as I made contact. Mm-hmm. And, you know, landed pretty good for landing on someone. Wasn't hurt, just after the fact was just so pissed, because I just haven't caught a break this year, you know? Like, usually I'd be like, whatever. I know it was a mistake, but I've just, you know, it's just one thing after the other lately this year. Like, I haven't had any luck on, you know, getting into these mains. But that night I knew I had the speed, qualifying 25th, and was confident in making it, and just that's what kind of like blew me up and made me blow up on A-Ray, you know.
Mm-hmm.
All right, obviously I wasn't there but for both of you, like, when the camera on TV panned to you guys and I just saw like a bunch of O'Neal, I thought maybe you guys were like gonna be tag teaming, no homo, Bubba. But like, why were you guys not fighting Bubba?
I mean, Bubba was just a fucking innocent bystander, right? Like, he was just, like, in the middle of it. I was trapped under his bike there for a little bit, and I was just like, I raised my hands up. He's like, oh, dude, the fucking flockers, dude. They're not doing their job. You know? That's what Bubba
was.
Yeah,
he could have hit the brakes, dude. He did not give a shit.
No. Dude, no. No, he didn't. That's...
He was yelling that?
Yeah, that's what he was saying. Because, I mean, I was under the bike, and I'm just like, what the fuck, right? That's what I said. I'm like, dude. And, yeah, it was the whole thing. I got pummeled by two bikes and a whoop on Saturday, so I'm freaking sore. But
you know that the way the bike smoked you, I almost expected Peacock to edit in the African dancing funeral.
Oh, dude, yeah.
Dude.
So bad.
So what did you get a front tire to your balls?
Yeah, and I mean, you guys know me. I already have a pretty gnarly testicle as it is. So, yeah.
That's right.
It's just like just a KX450 straight to it, you know? Yeah. There's no missing that thing either.
So did you have the ball smash pain?
No, I mean, honestly, like the adrenaline was rolling. I didn't even feel a thing.
Oh.
I didn't feel the bike landing on me. I didn't feel like, no. Fucking used to
it. Yeah, that probably upped the adrenaline rush a little bit.
Yeah, the second impact.
I'm so used to hitting the ground. As long as I don't land on my hands, I'm fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's funny because I was walking out of the stadium to come find you what happens. And, you know, you walk out of the tunnel and I see Deven. I'm all, hey, dude, what happened? And he says it and he goes, I was yelling. I'm all, why are you so damn sketchy? You know, like his merch.
Yeah. Yeah, although I did get DQ'd, I did pretty good on the merch this weekend.
Okay, so what happened? You go back to the tunnel. Did you get DQ'd, like, in the tunnel? They clip your transponder off right there when you're leaving?
No. Like, I walked out because my bike was, like, pretty mangled. Obviously,
dude, your
Devin's
bars
too.
Were jacked.
Yeah, bars were jacked, everything. So I walked out of the tunnel. This AMA lady, like, kept, like, stopping me, like, calm down. I'm like, I'm calm. I'm not really the one who's pissed, you know? Like, but, yeah, pretty much I go back to the truck. Or whatever, and then I was like, well, fuck, like, I'm going to go back down to AMA, because my mom's like, yeah, you're probably going to get fucking fined. You know, I'm like, all right, well, you know, so I ride the bicycle back down to AMA, and then, like, I see Thule, and he stops. He's like, yeah, well, like, you're done for the night. Like, you threw the first punch, like, you're done for the night. He's like, I'm on my way to tell Raper, like, he's done DQ'd too. I was like, all right. I was like, well, I told him, I was like, well, if there's a fucking fine, like, you're going to have to send it to me in payments because I'm broke as fuck. I ain't got no money. So, that's
pretty
much
it. Did you get fined?
Not yet.
Yeah, I'm claiming bankruptcy.
Yeah, not yet. Yeah, I'm claiming bankruptcy too. Yeah, but, not yet. But
they're not paying you your $1,000. For making the show?
I asked him. I don't really know. We'll see next Tuesday.
How did you get the news, Deven?
I went down to the tunnel, and you know how all the some of the privateers are pitting down inside. I was kind of early. I come through, and Stank Dog and like Crispy, so the guys are giving me a standing ovation and embarrassing me. But we're lining up. You know, I think. Or the, what do you call it, staging, and I see Thule walking up to me, and I'm staring at him like, you better not fucking disqualify me.
Shit.
And he comes up to me, he's like, I gotta disqualify you. I was like, I didn't even throw a punch. He came after me, I was just holding him down. He's like, nope, he hit you, and then you hit back. I didn't even remember that. I was like, damn, that was just like a natural reaction. I was like, yeah, shit, I guess I did.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, who made these fucking rules? Did you make them? He's like, they've been written a long time ago. I was like, well, you know, American law, if someone hits you, you're allowed to stand your ground, defend yourself. Like, why are the AMA rules worse than, you know, than the regular law? So I don't know. He just kept telling me, like, denying me. And I'm like, all right, well, I ain't going to win this battle. So. That sucks. He took my transponder and that was it. So
fuck. Yeah.
That's when I was pissed and I was like, all right. Cause after the race, like, or after I went waiting for him in the tunnel. I was just focusing on getting my bike straightened out and making a fucking main finally this year. And once the night was over, I went back to A-Ray's pit. I wasn't looking for a fight, but you know, I was just pissed because like the whole night was ruined over that stupid split second silly mistake, you know. And thankfully Cade came out. He's like, you guys just need to talk later. And I was like, I'm not trying to fight him, but tell his ass to come out here, like, what the fuck, you know. And good thing we didn't. And it's just unfortunate and getting a bunch of press that don't really want, but you know.
What do they say? No,
it sucks.
Bad press isn't bad press,
good press, or there's no such thing as bad press. Something I don't know.
Like that, yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's just been everywhere. It's already like to me, it's
I'm
already
not
fucking,
proud of it.
Yeah, it's already played
I'm not
out.
Proud of it. I haven't reposted anything or like condoned it or nothing like that. So, but yeah, it's been crazy. I've got like 1,500 followers overnight.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna ask. Yeah. Obviously, Alex has the merch line to benefit from this, but. What do you got? So, yeah, the followers, I guess that counts.
Yeah, I mean, like, got a lot of freaking, like, I mean, I got a lot of DMs. I got a lot of good ones. I also got a lot of bad ones.
Yeah.
You know, like, dude, you suck. Fuck you. Like, you know, like all that. And
I got a lot of DMs.
Yeah, I mean, it's just,
yeah,
it's terrible. Like, I mean, like, I told Deven in the text that I sent him this morning. I'm like, yo, dude, like, I'm a jackass. Like, I missed out on points. I missed out on money. Like, same as him. Like, he felt good. He wanted to make the main event. It's same as me. I mean, you get, like, it sucks, too. Like, I got my teammate out there. He getting 10th last weekend, 12th this weekend, you know? Like, you know, I mean, yeah, he's riding better than me this year. Obviously, I have a lot going on with myself. But, like, I mean, I could have been 15th all day. You know what I mean? And I missed out on those points, you know? And it's just
and
been
your whole family was there.
Yeah, my whole family was there. My mom, my dad. My dad's like, ah, goddamn, it's all right. But, you know, my mom's like.
Yeah, his dad is off. Hey, man, at least you can use tonight to heal up.
Yeah. My dad's like, yeah. He's like, he's just, anything I do, my dad just tries to find the positives out of it. He's like, yeah, you know, like, it's probably a blessing. Because my shit was hurting all day. It was just getting worse. And, I'm not even going to ride this week. So, just let it rest up and do better on Seattle. But, yeah, hopefully we can just put this shit behind us. I mean, it's already played out. It's fucking everywhere. I mean, Deegan reposted it. Supercross Live reposted it. Like, everyone reposted it. So,
hey, Deven, what kind of feedback did you get mostly from DMs and stuff?
Just good and bad. And, you know, all sponsors might not like that. I don't know. It's funny to see everybody's comments and, like stuff like these guys need boxing lessons and stuff. I'm like, well, damn, like we weren't there to fight. We're there to race. You know?
Yeah. I mean, and it's
and now, like, now I'm like getting judged on my boxing skills. I'm like, well,
fuck. It's like, it's one thing. Like, dude, we're in like full gear, right? Yeah. We're helmets, goggles, everything. Like half the time my fucking eyes were closed. I was just like, fuck, like what's going on? I felt like I was in the middle of a mosh pit.
Hay bales, dirt bikes.
And yeah.
Wearing moon boots, already redlined, just dodged three bikes and shit. Like,
yeah.
Just a break. You know?
Yeah. And then hey, you throw the flaggers and then you throw like the Alpine Star crew on top of it. Everyone's just like this. It was pretty much like a fucking mosh pit. Yeah. Like, dude.
Yeah. You know, the Alpine Star girl was like choking me. Or had arm from the back and around my neck. All right, we're done.
Yeah, I'm like, what the fuck, dude?
I think the thing that made it the most comical is you guys were identically dressed.
Yeah,
O'Neil
you guys
kit.
Are everywhere in the same O'Neal kit. But.
Yeah, I mean, even O'Neal got in on the memes, too, on freaking Instagram.
Yeah, what did you think of their meme? With
I don't know. I got a text from Frank, and I got a call from Mark this morning. Like, Frank, freaking owner at O'Neal. He's like, hey, man, like, seen what happened. You all right? I'm like, shit. And then, obviously, I got a call from Mark this morning, and, you know, like, I talked to him a little bit about it and everything. I was like, well, everyone's seen the new 2022 O'Neal gear this week, so, you know, hopefully they got something good out of it, and hopefully they sold some gear, and they liked it, so.
You guys probably got more TV time than if you would have made it into the main, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't show anyone.
100%. Yeah. And, dude, honestly, while we were, like, fighting on the track, the crowd, holy
dude,
shit.
They're going nuts.
Crazy.
I don't even know who won the heat race, but everyone was just like,
I was
screaming.
Taking notes for race report and I forgot to type. I just wrote A-Ray fight and then I was like, oh shit, who won?
Yeah, and like that's what like Cade too, because Cade was in the same heat race. He's like, dude, I hear the crowd erupt, and I'm like, what the hell's going on? And then I go through the whoops and I see these two just fucking fighting. Yeah, so
he's wearing the same gear as us too.
Yeah. Yeah.
He should have just
jumped in. Yeah.
Okay, so
yeah, off the top rope.
Now that you know things are settled down, and everything like looking back, and I'm sure you've seen it, both watched it, right?
Yeah.
Who won that fight?
Oh, probably Deven for sure. He had his fucking arm around my neck.
Yeah. I got a couple texts saying Deven won.
Yeah.
He's flailing his arms. I am not gonna let his hand grab my fucking helmet and pull me.
Yeah, dude.
So I just grabbed his hand and grabbed the back, and I was just trying to shove him down. Like, there's nothing you can do. You can't throw blows, but
yeah.
I don't know.
I think my finger hit your helmet because it's pretty fucking swollen this morning.
A-Ray, you know when you fucked up? When you kept touching your goggles. Every time I watch it, I'm like, why are you touching your fucking goggles? Stop!
When I first opened, like, open-handed him, like, that first swing I took, my finger caught the edge of his goggles and, like, ripped them off almost.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
As the whole thing happened, I'm, like, standing over by the starting line. And I just, like, I hear the crowd. And then I'm just like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. And then I was both like, yeah, same thing. Like, because I'm just seeing it all. And the whole crowd's just screaming. And I think my hands were up in the air, too, like, with my camera over my head. Like, yeah! It was great.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. I don't think any of those emotions would have happened if it wasn't for us both, like, just having an unlucky year. I think it was just, like, one more thing that just blew it over the top, and it was just like, fuck, man, you know what I mean? And I'm sure, you know, A-Ray is, you know, reacting like that, because it's just, like, one thing after another, and you just get fed up, you know?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's not like a thing between us, like us hitting each other. It's just both having.
No, I mean, Deven will tell you, I'm his biggest fan. I go over to him like every race. I'm like, hey, how's Deven today? Like, I'm clapping for him like every race. You know, like even Minneapolis, he was on the ground.
A-Ray's like a pesky little brother to me. He's always like, you know, side comments, talking shit, always rubbing it in if he's doing a little better. And you know, that's just our relationship. I've known him since we're like 19. You know what I mean?
Over
10 years now.
I was 16. I was like, whatever, because he was at Taft whenever I did the whole Supercross Academy.
Mm-hmm.
And like, I show up and they're like, who's this fat kid? Like, riding a 450 on the Supercross track. Cause I was 16. I still had a broken femur because I had broke my femur after Loretta's. I raced 250 or 450 B class at Loretta's. And then a couple weeks later, I'd broken my femur. And then, like, 6 weeks after that, me and my dad drove to California, and he just dropped me off. I had 2 450s. He dropped me off in Taft, California, and he's like, here you go. I'd never rode Supercross before, none of that. And then he just drops me off with 20 fucking pro guys. He's like, here, try to ride Supercross. I'm like, okay. And I'm like this 16-year-old fat kid, like, with my dad's credit card, not knowing a fucking thing, dude. Like, I remember I had – like Osiris shoes on, True Religion jeans, and Affliction shirt, trying to be cool. Like, I was the dumbest kid you'd ever met, right? And I'm there, and I'm racing with all these, or I'm practicing with all these dudes, and they're like, dude, who is this kid? And they would all get fucking pissed at me because I was fucking left, right, you know, closing my eyes through the whoops, just holding my bike wide open. They didn't know what to think, but yeah, and I've known Deven since then, so.
Do you remember how fat Alex was, Deven?
A-Ray is like the polar opposite of me. He takes more chances probably than anybody out there, but I don't take those crazy chances. You know what I mean? If I fuck up, I'll shut it down. He just sends it, and it's just two polar opposites. That's why he did that cross jump. I'm like, God damn it. What the fuck, man? Like,
yeah.
I don't know.
All right.
Yeah,
all right. Well,
he knew me when I was fat. Actually, my first ever Supercross. Check this out. Anaheim 1, 2011. Deven, was it your first year or is it your second year?
Second.
It was his second year, Anaheim 1. He qualifies 41st. I qualify 42nd. And that's the first year they did the alternate stuff, and he got in and I didn't. I had to watch. Yeah.
And then I remember Phoenix that year. He was in qualifying position, threw a huge-ass whip, and knocked himself out.
I scrubbed the triple so hard. I was on a fast lap. I scrubbed the triple. I was on a lights bike, 250F. Scrubbed the triple, just go straight into an endo. First thing that hits the ground is the front wheel, and it just fucking torpedoes my face into the ground. And I'm just out on the track, like just fucking out cold. Red flag the practice, everything. My dad's in the stands just taking pictures of me just out cold. Just spread eagle. Yeah, and I missed two races after that because I was just fucking knocked out. Black eye, everything.
Man. Okay.
It would have qualified that night, though.
Yeah, 37th. Yeah. 37th. Yeah, but I didn't get to race.
If it was this year, they probably would have let you lined up.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. All right, so is it safe to say everything's good now? Everything's cool?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Okay, good.
I was thinking about it on the way here. I was like, this would probably be pretty funny, but I could probably wear a Deven Raper O'Neal jersey on fucking Seattle track walk.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I need to start the merch line. I'm missing the bag.
Yeah.
You do. Yeah.
Your first shirt could say Victim of Sketch.
Yeah.
Victim of the Sketchy, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So, Deven, you're headed to Seattle, I assume?
Yeah, I could really use that money from the weekend to make it there, but I'm headed there. I am determined to make some mains, so I'll be there.
Bring your roll-offs. Bring your roll-offs.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be raining like
all
weather.
Week, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the thing about that, it levels the playing field a bit. Anything can happen, you know, so.
There you go. Let's not have any mud wrestling this weekend, okay, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Right. None of that.
All right. Hey, Deven, you want to shout out some of your sponsors?
Yes, definitely. I would like to thank RJC Racing, Kelly's Kawasaki, O'Neill, Crow Heat, my engine builder and modifier, Showa Suspension, and anybody else I forget. Oh, Lonesome Camel, CBD, for helping out some entries this year. And anybody else, thank you so much.
Right.
Yeah, and sorry for the bad publicity.
Yeah.
But what they say is bad publicity is good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, hey, man, thanks for calling in, Deven.
I will say that we did look good in our O'Neill gear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Deven. Good luck this weekend.
Later.
We'll see you
soon. See you, Deven.
Yeah.
All righty. Well, that was good. I was worried it was going to turn. Do you remember when you and I drove to Vegas to do Pulp and you and Tyler Bowers called in?
Yeah.
I was like sitting there. I was like, are they being serious?
Yeah, you just got to learn it. Yeah. Shortly after that, I learned to just embrace it, the whole sketchy deal. You know what I mean? Like, you kind of got to.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Okay, so on a more serious note, that track was gnarly. Right, like there are some guys saying it was worse than Detroit, but there was less big crashes than Detroit. But
yeah, but I don't even think in Detroit it was just a weird one. Like I don't think those crashes had anything to do with the track for the most part.
Yeah, the
it was just random scenarios, you know.
Yeah, but so many guys died in Detroit. But like,
yeah,
like dude, the one thing that caught my eye was there was one left-hand bull turn, and there was all these really deep, well-formed ruts through it.
Yep.
But the rut everyone was taking went high and squared it down and chopped down.
Like a Cooper Webb rut, yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know. A lot of peg dragging.
Mm.
And I thought that step-up jump into the sand was kind of gnarly.
Yeah.
Like, it looked like you guys were casing it on purpose to slow down.
Yeah, because, I mean, it was such a super, like, tight corner. And then, like, the inside had a wall, right? Mm-hmm. And, like, you're jumping, like, the single into the sand, but the sand is super soft, right? So it's kind of pulling you and tugging you. And
yeah.
I don't know. It was a tough corner.
Anton, did you notice a lot of guys crashed during practice sessions in the sand, but during the race it wasn't that much of a factor, was it?
Yeah, there
was.
I think they redid it. They redid that corner all day. Hey, Ray, can you tell that, too? Like, where they even moved the inside line, like, 5 feet further in. It seems like they even took, like, some sand down or spread it, and they maintained it. But that corner just like,
yeah.
I even saw it on Friday, and they were going to jump in. I'm like, how are you going to jump into a sand turn like that, and then expect the front end not to like not like that? Never made sense to me, and it never really shaped up any good. I don't think.
And two, like they kept working the outside of it because everyone was going fading out wide, and they were going into the other lane. So they kept making like a wall on the outside to get people to go back left into the whoops.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't that track designed by a fan or something?
Yeah, last year they did their Supercross game that they come out with every year. Last year they did that. That game has like a track editor on it. So last year they did a contest, and you could submit a track or whatever.
Well, then that's why I had that dumb left hand.
Yeah, that's why it was there. So,
You know, who I noticed is really good about like finding those new lines. He was doing it in practice. Obviously, is Jet. That rhythm after the finish that everybody was doing, he was the first guy to go all the way up to the right of the berm and then just chop down, because everybody else just kept going all the way into that very, very bottom line which was awesome. Like, that thing's got to feel so cool to just hook it into that thing and rip out of it that tight at the, like, not even use the berm.
Yeah.
But yeah, just how beat in that one corner got all night, you know, was unbelievable. At least they fixed it before the main event, but even like 10 minutes into it, it was cooked again.
Yeah. Jet kind of mentioned it in his heat race, podium speech or whatever. And yeah, it's kind of funny to think, but they have that MX simulator game and all these tracks are out the week or a couple weeks before. And Jet and our buddy Cade Matherly, they literally spend like probably two or three nights a week riding on the video game the same layout that they're going to race.
Really?
So yeah, those are actually like, they streamed it, I think, last week. Cade was like, hey, you could probably quad this with Jet, and Jet did it and stuff in the game. Yeah, it's really weird.
Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's unreal.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
That's like next level shit that nobody's ever thought about before.
Yeah, it's funny too, because that game, like, I can't even go in straight line, so you actually have to be good at the game to use that. Mm. But, yeah.
Hey, what did you think of that wall?
Gay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Before he crossed over the start?
Yeah.
Hey, but imagine
because
the
we were
lap
going three, and then whenever you land, there's a couple braking bumps, right? My hand's fucking blowing off. Mm-hmm. And then you land, and you're coming in with a lot of speed. Fucking front end just talks, dude.
Up
so
that
a lot of the times I was going like 3-3 outside the wall, or I'll go 3-2-1 to hit that wall. But a lot of the faster guys were going 3-3, and they were still making that turn, hitting the wall pretty well. But every time I hit it, I would freaking either overjump the three into it, freaking hit the braking bumps, freaking go straight. I went straight a couple times.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Off the track. Just
did
RJ did that too, I think.
Yeah.
Did you like that picture I sent?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Lord. That's what happened. I went 3-3, front end, like just washed right in, because you're coming in, you have a lot of pressure on your front wheel. Oh, sorry. You have a lot of pressure on your front wheel, and it just knifed.
He's going over the wall, and both his feet are back by the back.
Yeah, both my feet. I'm just Superman over the thing.
Yeah.
Come on.
The lap time would have been like 30 seconds without that wall, though.
Yeah. Anyone see the picture of Cade? His front end washed out right before it, and his face is just...
smashing
the wall, yeah. Visors all bent up in.
Smashing that goofy helmet into the wall. Yeah. You know what's funny is years ago, I went to Barsha's place in Florida to film him, and there was a thing like that.
Yeah.
This big wall scrub jump, and he was going up it and scrubbing so hard, he would put his foot down, like a foot plant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Over it. And I got a photo of him doing that in Indy.
Really?
It was the weirdest
looking
thing.
Was that in
thing.
Practice?
Yeah, I think it was practice, but
I
he just like
too.
Put his foot down, poof, and planted it. But he's so aggro though. Like,
mm-hmm. Dude, it's badass
he's
to watch. I think
always as a photographer, you could hear him coming.
Yeah,
you know, and then you could always count on him doing something for the camera. That's kind of nutty.
It's impressive, especially when he's next to Tomac, because those Austrian bikes are so quiet, especially compared to a Yamaha,
mm-hmm.
and the bike is so damn loud. Like,
yeah,
he's just revving it out.
Yeah.
So is this four in a row for Tomac?
Yeah, four
wow.
in a row.
Yeah.
Dude, he could clinch this thing three mm-hmm. races early. I mean, if he gets on a roll, like, I mean, he's got six races left.
What's his point
dude,
gap now?
He could have went out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
50 something.
No, 48, I think.
Jesus, wow. Dude.
Yeah, he could went out, honestly. Like, he could – the rest of these tracks that are coming up are tracks that he's not bad at either.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Big layout at Atlanta. He's good in St. Louis. He's – Ben, I mean, Denver is like where everybody's like, wouldn't that be great to clinch it at his home race? Yeah, he's
altitude
probably gonna do
as
that.
Well.
That would be sick.
Yeah. Two altitude races, yeah. It's unreal. It's kind of wild, too, to see how everybody else's attitude has shifted now, regardless of this, like, championship thing. Like, all right, if I can't win the title, I either got to be in the points chase or I'm chasing bonus money with race wins or podium finishes or whatever. Everybody's mind is just dollar signs now.
Mm.
Is Barsha second in points now?
Yeah. Him and Jason are tied now.
What?
If he wouldn't have gotten Doc the 3 points,
oh,
he'd
right.
be up three on Jason, yeah.
Yeah. So wow. he's on probation?
Yeah, from the – what? Who did he get in? Was it
he's on probation
oh,
for
Bogle,
the
Bogle
thing.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
So
– Well, and then I guess he did something in practice too, because I guess at the podium he like automatically knew like, oh, man, they're going to come say something to me. And maybe he had even been warned about something he had done earlier in the day, but he knew kind of right away, like, oh man, this isn't going to go like away. No problems.
Mm-hmm. At what point I mean, when a rider's on probation and things like that happen, at what point do they really enforce a penalty instead of like 3 points? And
it was a fine, right? But
$5,000,
$3,000,
three. Yeah, and I think it depends too, because, and this kind of goes along with the inconsistencies in the AMA thing. Sometimes it's like a suspended fine, so like you pay the $3,000, or you don't have to pay the $3,000 unless you do something again.
Yeah.
But I think with this one, it's like, no, you're paying right now. Mm-hmm. You know, $3,000 isn't anything. No, like, that's pocket change for what he was.
Yeah.
I was more surprised even that he didn't put up a bigger fight against Eli. You know, I was like really thinking like he's gonna at least have to bump Eli to.
Well, dude, Eli's pass was
to
so
do something, but
good. Like, he passed him and got away instantly. And like, I was asking him after the race, I was like, you know, when you pass Barsha, do you plan it so you could pass him and throw down a heater to get away so you can get smashed back?
Yeah.
He's like, oh, that's definitely the strategy you have to take with him.
Yeah.
But yeah, I talked to Jason in the rig afterwards, and he was kind of fine. He's in a bad mood, obviously, but then I pulled my camera and I was like, hey, you in the mood? And he goes, fuck no, and walked away.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was bad. And then Malcolm, dude, poor he's dude. Jacked up. He's got a big old hematoma in his butt. One of his butt cheeks is even bigger right now.
Oh, my gosh. That section was gnarly. I did it a couple times in practice, in the first practice. But second practice, or first time qualifying, I did it. And then the second qualifying, the last one of the day, I couldn't do it. The turn was pretty jacked up. So
that's where Jet was casing, too, that triple A.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, it was gnarly.
Mm. Yeah, I don't know. He got hunted down by his bike, though. It hit him in the ass, I think.
Yeah, that was not good.
I think better his ass than his back, though, right?
Like, yeah.
Thank God he was two laps ahead of everyone else, though. Cause
yeah, right? He laid on the ground for a long time,
yeah,
and still
lap.
Gets eighth.
Yep.
So, yeah, I think they lapped up into sixth place, right?
That's
yeah.
gnarly. I mean, that's insane. That's what happens whenever the track has, like, those short lap times, and the track gets super gnarly.
43 seconds.
Yeah. Right? I mean, yeah. You have like the top elite guys who aren't slowing down with the ruts. And then you have the guys after that who are taking their, you know, time a little bit with the ruts. Cause I mean, did you guys see the pictures? I mean, they were, I mean, you guys were on the side of the track. It was gnarly. It's always like that at Indy, but holy shit, man.
Yeah. Yeah. Anton, weren't you like down there shooting, just going, oh my God, there's like, you know, because the battle for the lead was those five guys, right? And they're just going through packs of five lappers. Like,
Chaos. I've seen a lot of tweets like of people saying like, hey, if you get lapped twice, and just
black flag.
Get black flag, yeah.
That's bullshit. That's so stupid. What? So you're going to have six guys on the track?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's a thing.
Like, that's the people that like say that kind of stuff and always want to tweak with the format, they just kind of don't know what they're watching, because like, there's so much stuff going on that every guy's got to be out there to make this thing happen. There's dudes battling for top 20 in the championship that's worth another 10 grand. They have to be out there. You can't clip them and say that they're done because they're not out there. That's you know, it's so dumb.
I think there's like
and I think
3 points
too, like
with
even
the guys separating.
Yeah, between
Cade,
Breeze,
and
Starling.
Yeah.
And the three guys that needed the points the most got flipped in the results this weekend, because Cade was better last week and was ahead, and then Breece and Starling caught him this weekend because they finished better than him. And it's that's the cool shit. Like, that's the fun stuff. You got to have those dudes out there.
Yeah.
I think you just got to
make the tracks longer, like the best you can. It can't be like under 50 seconds. It's just, that's what happens. Every time we see a track under that low, this is exactly what happens.
Yeah, there was no time. The lap times were so short, and the guys are coming back around again. You couldn't like change your camera settings if you want to try something different.
No, yeah.
Like, oh, that fuck, here he comes again. I don't know. But I was thinking about the whole lapper thing. Remember that announcer Larry Huffman?
Yeah.
Or you don't? You,
I
you
don't.
Do.
Yeah.
I think he's maybe the one who coined the term. Like, if you see the blue flag, it means there's a race going on.
You're
not
in
it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. But so okay, you would know. And how was your weekend? Cade was like snapping about like being lapped and the people lapping him fucking with him.
Really?
Yeah, he says he was mad. He said like, you know, like, yeah, I'm getting lapped.
Early.
Oh yeah, you did.
Yeah,
I'm getting lapped and, you know, doing my best to stay out of the way, but they're yelling at me and fucking with me. He goes, I'm about to snap back. So he was, he was all pissed off because he goes, I'm racing too, you know, which
he
is.
Exactly. So, yeah, I mean, it's a slippery slope, you know, whenever you're talking about lappers and getting lapped. And, you know, I mean, we're out there. We're trying just as hard as they are. You know, we're, you know, obviously we're not on the same level. But at the same time, you know, we're still doing our best as well. So sometimes it's like heat of the moment, man. Middle of the race. Adrenaline's high. People are pissed. You know?
So, man, in the fourth, well, let's round up the 450s before we go to commercial. But a lot of good finishes by guys, like some career bests, like Ryan Breese got 10th.
10th, yeah.
He was so pumped after the race. And you know what? One thing I noticed about him is he's one of the guys that still runs the, what do they call it now? The nose thing.
Intake.
Intake. Oh. Yeah, he runs it still. I think, does Cooper Webb still run it?
I think Dino does.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's still there. I mean, it's still an amazing product. I just wonder why it's kind of faded off. But anyway, yeah, he was pumped. His how was your weekend was pretty funny. He's all, I was like, hey, congratulations, man. We're talking. And he's like, oh, man, I just got to thank everyone. I got to thank my family, my sponsors. You know, I got to thank myself.
Yeah, hell yeah.
He's right, because you got to always thank yourself.
Yeah, because he had a tough year last year. He missed the whole season with the torn ACL. You know, so, I mean, this is his comeback season, and he's doing really good.
Yeah. But then he's like another, he's one of the only guys out there in a Rye.
Yeah.
A Rye helmet. It's funny because a Rye runs some advertising with us, and they're always asking us to like get them photos and stuff. I'm like, oh, Breese runs in a Rye.
Yeah.
So all I could think about is Breese and Yoder.
Yeah, that team runs them. That's it, though. I don't think any other 450 guys run.
Yeah.
A-Ray used to run an Arai.
I know. I that's my favorite setup of A-Ray was the Arai, O'Neill, and A-Stars. Or CDs.
CDs. Yeah, it looked good. It was a good setup on the factory Yamaha. But, yeah.
Do you still have the Monster Arai hanging up somewhere?
Dude.
Yeah? Duh. Is it in, like, a little case?
No, it's at home in my room hanging up, though. It's all
he
good.
Still has all his hats.
I have all the hats.
Yeah,
I have team shirts. I have the jackets. Hat. I have, like, the water bottles. I have every
single
have,
like,
set
the,
of gear. All of my butt patches.
Helmet?
Yeah.
Is it like right where, like when you bring a chick over, is it the first thing they see?
It's like right. Okay, so it's in my room in Tennessee. So it's like you got my TV, and it's like right underneath my TV, like on my little dresser thing right here. Yeah. So like it's straight angle from the bed.
So like, you know, when you see like chicks that spend the night, you always see them in movies like in the guy's dress shirt the next morning.
Yeah.
She like, here, wear this Yamaha Monster Energy kit shirt.
Yeah. No, I tell him to wear the O'Neill jersey with the big Monster logo on it with all like the factory Yamaha sponsors on it.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. But
okay.
But now Sam's been wearing like the new team tee that I have like with SG. All of my team SGB the, team the sponsors. Sketchy. Yeah.
Nice.
She's got her little XL. She walks around. Nice. It's great.
Yeah.
She's awesome.
So, what else? Who else did good in 450s? There was a guy that made the
Cooper
main
Webb.
For the first time.
Cooper
Dude,
Webb.
He's gnarly.
Yeah, he's gnarly. I mean, to come back from that last week and to get, what, fifth?
Yeah.
Fifth. Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's amazing. You know, he was all taped up. You know, I seen under his jersey, and yeah, he was probably riding through some pain, but he's a freaking gnarly dude.
Dino had his best finish of the year.
Seventh, right?
Yeah. Yeah, there was some firsts in the 450 main, I think, this year. Tristan Lane made it out of the heat race. Rod Bell made his second main out of the heat.
Threw up everywhere.
Did he?
Yeah.
All over his jersey?
Yeah, and his chick had throw up on her.
Oh, yeah, that's how that's how it happens, man. He throws up. This is his teammate last year, you know, the last couple of years in outdoors. I've never seen somebody throw up so much. I mean, everybody has, like, their weird thing, right? Like, I get so nervous, I piss myself.
You pee yourself?
On the gate, yeah. I'll go to the bathroom like 10 times for the heat, for the last practice, everything, right? I'm still on the gate, like, fuck. Every now and then I'll get so nervous, I'm just dribbling. Just dribble. So bad.
So, yeah, Cooper, what did he say? Within the first sentence, he said, fuck. And how was your weekend?
Like he's a lot more loose with the language this year. Even on
a fucking painful weekend.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, you know who was Brad Carnell when he won the LCQ?
His title sponsor this weekend was a chick from OnlyFans.
Right?
Yeah. She had like 500 subs.
On OnlyFans?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
That's what I seen.
Did you hear about this, Chase?
No, I heard, but I didn't know she was like that big. Jesus.
Yeah. Well, Carnell.
Homegirl made 10 grand this weekend.
From Carnell's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're pumped.
She better be signed up the rest of the year.
She was an engineer, apparently, and quit her job because the thing's paying better.
Huh.
Wow.
Yeah.
10 grand in a day? I mean, shit, ain't bad.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm going to put Carnell on my bike. Sup?
So when he wins the LCQ, he was so fired up, right?
Heck yeah.
And he's getting interviewed. And he's like, I don't know. My bad. What's the black dude's name, the announcer? He does a good job.
I have no idea.
Oh, Joseph. Yeah.
Anyway, so he's interviewing him. And then they kind of wrap up the interview, and he's all, yeah, yeah, so good job, man. We'll see you in the main. And Carnell goes, yeah, man, let's fucking go. And I see the black dude go, and he puts his hand over the bike.
Oh, my gosh.
It was good, though.
Heck, yeah.
Yeah. That guy is like a Jason Anderson dude. He never tucks his jersey in.
No, really never. Does. No, it's all the way around.
And his jerseys are long, though.
Yeah.
FXR jerseys.
Yeah, he's done that for years.
I don't like that look. Honestly,
it looks crusty. Look at LBZ jersey.
I like when Anderson does it, though.
It's just the bat.
Yeah, Anderson's just the bat.
Hart Raft made him opening ceremonies.
Yeah, he was so stoked. So stoked. He had a crash, had a tip over in the beginning of the main event. He was bummed on that. He missed out on a lot of points. He had another opportunity for top 10. I talked to him a little bit yesterday. He was bummed out on it, but I mean, he had a high and low weekend, right? He, checked off something off of his bucket list. I mean, he came out at opening ceremonies, you know, they let him pick a song and everything.
They did? Yeah. That's good. 'Cause they weren't letting people pick.
Yeah. And he's just freaking like the straightest Brandon Hart Raft face ever. Just revving his bike.
Yeah, right.
And then like he stops and like throws his freaking goggles. He's like, dude, the crowd went crazy when I threw my goggles.
Yeah, he was pumped.
Yeah, he was so stoked.
I heard that when they were hitting him up about what music he wanted, he had a very nice list of songs. Like, he had a lot of options just for them to edit around. He was very excited about this.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I even gave him a couple off of my phone, too. That Get Loose song, but he said that was a bit aggressive. But he did the Open Your Eyes.
It should have been the theme from Rocky IV.
I know.
You know?
Or like a Russian, just like the Russian song.
Yeah.
It's probably not good.
Right? Not the time for that. Not the time for that. Yeah, come on. Yeah. I heard Cade is getting one for next week.
No way.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Cade's getting open ceremonies?
He might be, yeah.
Uh-huh. I heard that.
2 weeks in a row. I mean, he went 10, 12.
Nice.
And, he was asking this weekend. He was asking this weekend, too.
If he could be
I
in
was
it?
Told they were... Mm-hmm. I was told that filmers were pointed out, please get additional case and clip or Clayson clips like you've never gotten before, and just in case.
Yeah.
Wow. I should send them the footage I got in the pits of Sarah polishing his LS2 helmet. That helmet is so bad. Anyway, all right, let's take a quick break here from our sponsors. We'll be back for more.
Racetech is the world's largest aftermarket motorcycle suspension modification company with over 35 years experience personalizing your suspension setups. Racetech Gold Valves provide a plush feel which drastically improve bottoming resistance and increase traction.
Hey everyone, it's Pierce Brown of the Troy Lee Red Bull Gas Gas team. Gas Gas motorcycles are the fun and approachable launchpad into the performance off-road motorcycle world. With a rich heritage in off-road motorcycle racing and trails competition, Gas Gas has a distinct, vibrant, and inviting style with a playful, proudly Spanish character.
Hey everyone, Don Moyetta here. Over the past 20 years, I've built a ton of cool motocross project bikes. When it comes to choosing a great wheel set, my first call is always to the crew at WUSA. Importers and distributors of Talon, Kite, Hahn, and Edge hubs, the wheel building team at W is unrivaled when it comes to lacing them up to DID or Excel rims. Let's be honest now. Next, cleaning air filters or changing oil. Tightening spokes is one of the most tedious jobs when it comes to working on your bike. When it comes to wheel sets from W, though, you know that they'll stay straight and true, and the spokes will almost always stay tight. There's a reason that factory teams and top riders everywhere rely on W. When it comes to anything wheel-related, your one-stop shop is WUSA.com. Check them out.
Hey, this is Colt Nichols of the Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha team, and I rely on Guiltless Food Co. to keep me fueled properly, feeling 100%, and is super convenient. It's healthy food that doesn't suck. Sign up at guiltlessfoodco.com.
Out here, on the edge, failure is no option. Here, you don't compromise. Off-road, on-road, on the track, off the grid. Sunstar sprockets and brake discs come installed on more motorcycles and all-terrain vehicles than any other in the world. Period. The engineers who design your bike trust and spec Sunstar for the same reason you should. Because here, on the edge, failure is no option. Sunstar, number one in sprockets and brake discs.
What's up? This is Christian Craig. As a motocross racer, being in top physical shape is a must, and my favorite way to train is cycling. And whether it's road biking or mountain biking, I rely on Roy Cyclery to keep my bikes in perfect running order.
Roy Cyclery has been servicing Old Town Upland, California since 1962. Mention the Swapmoto Life podcast for additional discounts in the shop.
Hey guys, it's Ryan Villapoto. Now that I'm living the retired life and not bound to factory team sponsors, I'm able to choose my partners when it comes to building my bikes. I choose Backyard Designs to create my motorcycle graphics because they do a great job. Their kits look great, go on easy, and last long.
Backyard Design has the most comprehensive and user-friendly graphic website in the sport. Use the discount code SWAPMOTO at checkout for a discount at backyarddesignsusa.com.
Everyone, welcome back to the Kickstart Podcast presented by Pro Taper.
And AlexRay.co.
AlexRay.co today. 250 class. And Jet Lawrence was finally challenged a little bit by Cameron McAdoo.
Yeah.
I was psyched to see that.
Dude, smart racing by such a young kid, right?
Yeah. He told me, he goes, I got up front and I pull a lead. And he goes, and I cruised too early. Because, like, did you notice he was, like, jumping the whoops?
Yeah.
Early on?
Yeah.
But yeah, he – I don't know. It seems like – as a racer, isn't it hard to settle into a pace and then have to go faster?
Yeah, it's very hard.
Yeah, because, I mean, he settled in the pace pretty damn early.
Yeah, and for him to be able to wick it back up pretty much any time he wants, I mean, dude, that says something.
Yeah. You know?
I mean, the kid is top-notch. But, hey, props to McAdoo. I mean, he ran the pace. He was there pretty mm-hmm. much the whole time. I mean, he was – like, if Jet makes a mistake in any of this, I mean, it's going to be McAdoo, right? McAdoo, they've been 1-2 the whole season, it seemed like. I mean, yeah, there was a couple guys in there that slipped in a second, but for the most part, it's just been the McAdoo and Jet show.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I mean, it's a great race to watch.
Yeah. Sure. But so the heat race, dude, that first turn crash was gnarly.
Yeah.
And right. did his forearm get run over?
Yeah,
by?
Yeah, it got ran over.
Wow.
Yeah, he's super lucky. But
dude, that had like three different ways that it could have went bad. From like mm-hmm. when he could have dabbed his knee,
yeah,
to when he could have like put his shoulder or his wrist out, when he put his arms down to get tagged by a bike. Like, that was unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
That was unbelievable what he was able to roll out of.
Do you think, Anton, do you think if Pierce didn't crash, Joe would have caught him still?
No. No, because even on Chisholm, like, it took him up until the last little bit to catch Chisholm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, and Pierce was well ahead of that. I was really hoping Kyle could have held him off a little bit. That would have just been so cool. Because that's probably going to be Kyle's best chance to do that, you mm-hmm. know?
Props to Kyle for fighting back, though.
Hell yeah.
Sick.
Yeah, dude. And, yeah. Even on the Cameron thing, like, that battle that they were having, you know, on TV, they're like, this is so important for Jet because now he's riding under this pressure and stuff. It's like, well, no, dude, it's also important for Cameron because Cameron needs to go show that he has the raw speed to chase him down and pass him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the more important for everybody than just Jet out there.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Okay. You and I always disagree on kits.
I'm ready for this. Right?
I thought Jet's whole all red everything was pretty good.
Yeah, no, not a fan of that kit. Not a fan. I was not a fan of a single kit this weekend, I don't think.
Really?
There was nothing that was.
Well, I mean, I wouldn't wear that all red. I'd look like Santa Claus. But the red boots, red gear, red plate, red Honda, I thought it was good.
Yeah, it's not a fan. I didn't like the yellow and the green and the blue on the gear, too. Too many colors.
Yeah, but you like his white and
yellow?
Yellow.
The egg one?
Fried egg
gear?
Yeah,
I'd buy that. I would buy it.
Isn't it funny the way we just always...
Yeah, I don't understand it.
Always opposites.
Opposite. Jeez. Mm-hmm. So, RJ Hampshire got third.
That's
kind of a lonely third way back.
That's his first podium this year?
Yeah.
That's nuts.
That is crazy. I think Pierce gets third if he doesn't crash in the heat race. I'm sure he was riding through some freaking pain, man. I mean, he looked good all day, you know.
Do you think he went out?
I was watching it. He was moving a lot for someone that was out. I don't think he was out.
I think he just got the wind knocked out of him. He was laying on his back, and he was moving around. He was just,
even, like, as bikes came, every time he heard a bike get close, he flinched his legs, like, moved his legs up or something. Oh,
yeah.
Like, I don't think
because
he was out.
That was a discussion I heard between the Alpine Stars medic guys. Like, and then the way the track is done, right, he crashes and he's can't race. So he still has to sit on a hay bale or wait inside before he could leave. But I heard them saying, like, was he out? Was he out? Do you think he went out? And they're debating that.
I mean, definitely a hard hit, though.
Yeah.
Oof.
I think, I think he could have pulled off third, but he said it started hurting too much at the end.
Yeah, I'm bummed for him because the speed's definitely been there this year. And I know they worked a lot on, like, consistency and staying on the bike this year. And he's had some pretty good ones. So, bummer for Styles, too.
Yeah, he hurt his wrist
during
the week or something. Yeah.
Missed out on all that whole shot exposure.
Mm-hmm.
250s. That guy got 10th. The Phoenix Honda kid.
Oh, yeah.
Cullen Park.
Yeah, Park.
Yeah, Park.
Nice.
Yeah, my teammate got third in the heat race.
Yeah, Nice.
Yeah.
He was on it all day. Even in practice, he looked really good.
He qualified like 13th or something.
Yeah. Another Oldenburg from the second they showed him in practice. He was the first guy I saw on TV hit that quad, like, over the on-off.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, he looked good all day.
Yeah, that's what I was telling someone, like, in the stands. Like, Oldenburg is always, like, one of the first dudes to pull the big stuff. Like, he's not scared to jump something.
Yeah.
Do you think he goes back to 450 in Seattle?
I think so. Yeah.
For one round?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is Chiz?
Yeah, I think so. I think he might be, like... I don't know. I might have heard something like they just put him on the Star 450. I don't know.
Oh, for Dylan?
Yeah. I don't know that. Yeah. Don't quote me on that. I mean, obviously, he has all of his, you know, main, you know, LS2 X-Brand sponsors.
Dude,
that would
be weird if he goes back to all his other gear for one race.
Yeah.
No.
I don't know. I mean, I heard that, but I don't know if it's true. So don't quote me on it.
Did any of you ask why was Chiz in, like, six-year-old A-Stars last weekend?
He had those at his house that he had broken in, like, back whenever he was on HEP. He's very, very finicky with boots.
Okay.
Very finicky. Yeah.
That makes sense.
Okay. He likes a broken boot. Mm-hmm. We'll just leave it at that. Hmm. Yeah.
All
right. He likes his neck brace, too.
Mm-hmm.
He's wearing that. So the Cullen Park guy, he was the only rider into that semi.
Yeah, what happened to...
Peters is out.
And what happened to Osby?
Osby got fired. They let him go. Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. Poor performance.
Poor performance, yeah.
Huh.
Hmm. Yeah. And then he raced this weekend. He raced
Welton's practice bike, right?
Welton's practice bike. He was in Welton's gear. On press day. Literally had Welton 285 on the back.
Wow.
And, he put it in the main event.
Huh.
Yeah. So, on someone else's practice bike.
That's pretty nutty.
Yeah.
What did he finish?
It was his home race. I don't know what he finished. I think it was around 15, 16. Anton, do you know?
Yeah, he made it through the LCQ. I mean, that was good. And I mean, you know, Josh was going well. I'll look it up right now.
I think it was a career best, too, for Welton. I think he was 13.
We just lost Anton. You know, it's funny is on his – I love the YouTube comments, right? His news break. Someone writes –
I went to unlock the phone and I accidentally hit the red button.
Yeah. But Anton, did you see on your news break comments on right? Oh, sick. I didn't know Donnie Osmond was racing. I knew who that was about instantly when I saw that. But, props to Hunter Yoder making his first main.
Menifee's own.
Yeah, it's funny because I walked past him and, you know, Hunter and I've been buddies for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And I walked over to him on Friday when I saw him. I was like, he's all. You're here. And I was like, dude, I came to Indy just to watch you make your first main. Don't let me down. He's like, oh, Dad, it's on. It's on.
That's sick.
And it's funny because then he's in ninth place
in
the heat. And I was in the turn right before the wall and two laps in a row when he come by. I was like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But they DMs me right after the race. I saw you. But, yeah. And then that was a good thing.
I'm stoked for him.
It was the eve of his 18th birthday too, right?
Yep.
So he made the main. And he said his rear brake went out or something.
Oh, that's a bummer.
But he was pumped because I texted him because I was like, I got to get him for how was your weekend after the race. And so as soon as I got out in the pits, I texted him like, hey, where are you? Because I didn't know where his pit was. And he goes, oh, I just pulled out of the pits. I'm leaving. And I was like, fuck. And he's all, where are you? I'll come back in. And I'm at the Husky Rick. And he just comes running in and does how his weekend.
He's awesome.
But, yeah, stoked for him.
Yeah, it's good.
Did you look up what you needed, Anton?
Well, I'm trying to find the – I was looking for the results. I'm trying to get to that right now. But I thought you were talking about Yoder. 1 second.
Yeah. Yeah, but Yoder, I think he was credited with 21st or something, but still, first main.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Stoked for him.
Hey, did
21st, yeah.
How'd Drake do? I saw he was deep.
Yeah, 12th, he was deep. Yeah, I think he clawed his way back to 12th.
Oh, good
qualifying
good.
For him, 7th. 7th in qualifying, made it out of the heat really well. And then, yeah, I think he just got a terrible start, put himself in a bad position. It was a tough weekend for him and his chick. I think on Friday they got hit by a car on their bird scooter.
Oh no!
Yeah.
So oh shit!
Yeah,
I saw
she hurt
was in
her,
the
yeah,
hospital. Yeah.
No, she just I think she might have had an allergic reaction or something too. But she hurt her ankle pretty good. You know, the freaking car. Oh, like I guess they were turning and then the car didn't see him. And you know, they just hit him. But like, Derek like rolls her over, sees that she's good. He's like, "All right, get up!" Freaking picks her up. Yeah, the bird scooter was like underneath the car. He pulls the bird scooter out, rips the bumper off. He's like, "Oh fuck!" You know, just it was nuts. But yeah,
dude,
tough way to start the.
Were they two up on it or were they? Dude, there was a lot of people on those things in the streets.
Yeah, nuts.
I think when I left the track, there's dudes like in the road, like in the left turn lane and stuff. Aren't you supposed to ride them on the sidewalk, or are you supposed to ride them like a car?
I think it's a free-for-all.
Yeah, I think it's a free-for-all, pretty much.
So he gets hit. Does he file a police report, or is he just like, ah, fuck it?
No, but I think the cops did come. The cops came. The paramedics came. Like, it was a whole deal. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because, like, I guess someone seen it and called 911. It's like, hey, I called 911. I'm a nurse.
Mm.
Yeah, it was, like, a big old ordeal. But
his chick had to go to the hospital.
She was no, I don't think so. No, she was limping
in
around.
Doctors or something,
no,
though.
She was limping around on Saturday, but I think she was okay.
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn. Just give a ride those things. I don't know. What else?
You know, got some new stuff on alexray.co. If you want to talk about that, I got this new sketchy as hell hoodie. The shirt did really well, so I figured
did
I would
you make
put it
the
on
sketchy
hoodie.
Lifestyle one?
Not yet, no. Should we do a collab? Because it does have like somewhat of a Swapmoto Live.
It's like a retarded lightning bolt. It's
yeah. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. Do you want to do something of that?
Maybe we should.
I'm down.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it's not just about being sketchy on a dirt bike. It's a lifestyle, you know, whether, you know, you just sketchy.
On a mountain bike?
In general. Anything. On a mountain bike, freaking with chicks, you know. Anything. Like, if you're a chick and you're sketchy with dudes, hey,
it's
whatever. It's a lifestyle, you know what I mean? But, yeah, I got some new stuff on there. Just, you know, this shirt did really well, so I put it on a hoodie. And then, obviously, I have the flame, sketchy flame stuff. I have that in a hoodie and a t-shirt. Ordered some more stuff. I have a new team tee. You know, it has all the...
It's like an SGB team?
Yeah, it's like an SGB team. It has my name and number on the side with a little bit of sketchy logo. And then I have the new sketchy Reaper tee, too.
Hey, you know what's funny? Remember when I came Friday and it was raining?
Mm-hmm.
So I was wearing, like, a big, heavy jacket. But it was raining Friday, but it wasn't cold.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, my wall. Dude, I have that 7 windbreaker, the camo windbreaker, in the cabinet.
Yeah.
And I went up there, and there was I couldn't find it, right?
Yeah.
I'm like, damn it. And I asked Cade, did you guys throw my jacket away? And he's like, oh, I don't know. And I go, the cabinet in there is Nice gear. And he goes, well, I'll ask him. Maybe he did something with it. I was like, oh, okay. And then later on, I'm like coming out of press day, and I see him wearing it. And I'm like, nah, maybe that's not mine, you know?
Yeah.
Then it showed up race day.
Oh, shit.
It's kind of funny.
Yeah.
So I think I shoved my stuff in the, You know, like where you sit?
Yeah.
The cabin above you in the corner.
Yeah, I think that's mine.
It's in there now with my photo vest and that.
Yeah, just put my put your stuff in my locker.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It's in there. Well, see, I thought that locker was mine because Niece wasn't around, right?
Yeah, well.
Huh. Kicked out.
It happens.
All right. Anton, anything to add? Hey, how was the tour racetrack that you took on press day?
What was that?
Didn't you go on that that
tour? Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that was cool. That was really cool to see. I've done that before, you know, just to go see Indy Motor Speedway. But that was cool that they took us over there and showed us some backstage stuff of it. Mm-hmm. We got to ride around the track in a Suburban at like 110 miles an hour in the rain.
Sick.
And the guy was just mellow, like no big deal. But it sounds like there's going to be like kind of more of that. They want to introduce, you know, Supercross to more people, and especially to like more racing audiences. They're going to just kind of piggyback off other racetracks that are in the area.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, that's cool. That's what we kind of need to do, because they try to do that with like having Kurt Busch there and stuff. So to see them do it like that is cool. Hey, Ray, the one thing I want to talk to you about before we let you go on this whole thing, did you do local media in Indy over the weekend?
Mm-hmm. I did, yeah.
I thought I could not stop laughing at the idea. Sorry about the dog. That everybody in the country has been introduced to you on like Friday morning news, Thursday afternoon, whatever. Just all these people with just a hey, come see Supercross. You then reintroduce yourself by getting in a fight. I just
it's
like, God damn, Alex, yeah. You are just like on another level when it comes to the media integration. You got it aced. Nobody's got it like you, dude.
Yeah, I know. I feel like my face has been everywhere this year, good and bad. But yeah, I don't know, man. It's I have nothing to say about it. I don't know. I feel like I acted kind of like a jackass this weekend. But hell, you know, you live and you learn, right? Can't take it back now. Might as well embrace it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, it's all good. It's all good. Are you in for Seattle? Everything's good?
Oh, yeah. I think so. I haven't really talked to the AMA at all. They said that I was done for the night. So hopefully, you know, everything's good. So,
is Sam coming to Seattle?
No, I'm bummed about it.
So since you outed her on Instagram, has she really gotten a bunch of followers?
Not a bunch. No, but she's gotten a few. Yeah. Fucking terrible.
Should have never done that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
I got a message from truck driver Taylor about it.
Yeah.
He gave me shit for doing it, too.
Yeah. Like,
what?
Both of us. He's like, man, you can't do that.
Yeah.
You got to keep a chick secret.
Yeah.
Oh. All right, guys. Well, thank you for listening to the Kickstart Podcast presented by Pro Taper, makers of the ACF handlebar that we all love and trust. And we'll talk to you next Monday after a very wet and rainy Seattle.
Since 1991, Pro Taper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, Pro Taper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more.